Hey y'all, it's your girl, the Evelyn Chanel, and I am back at you with another video. So, let me just start by saying Happy Halloween, or whatever, and it is the last day of October. Y'all already know how I feel about October. It's my birthday month or whatever like that. And, you know, in honor of Halloween, I decided I'm going to tell a spooky story or whatever. Have Bible study, so it wasn't anything out of the blue. Leading up to that, we were excited, we were talking about it, and the day comes. So like I said, it was on a Wednesday, and it was during the normal time that we have Bible study. So we got to Bible study, whatever like that, and we got ready to load up the church vans to go. And so, you know, like I said, y'all, we excited. But let me tell y'all something about your girl. I be all down for going to a haunted house until I get there. And like I said, this ain't no haunted house, but it still was giving off the same feelings in the stomach. I feel a little rumbly in my tumbly, okay? A little nervous. So, you know, we're getting ready to go, whatever like that. We get on the van and we get there. Now, like I said, this was a big thing when they was having it. Like, of course, with any other haunted house, you know, the lines be long or whatever like that. And child, like it was long lines to get into this church house. So we were waiting in line, you know, like I said, long line. But of course we had to stay together because we was leaving together, so we all went as a group together. So we getting ready to go, and the closer we get to going in, the more nervous I was getting to going in, you know, whatever. Like any normal 13-12 year old, well, I ain't gonna say normal, because some are 13, 20 year olds, they be ready to do some crazy stuff, but not me. I be talking, and I be like, yeah, let's go. In reality,
no ma'am, no ma'am, no ma'am, no ma'am.
I'm scary. I don't like being scared, okay? First off, I don't like being scared. Let's just start there. When I get scared, I be ready to fight, okay? Fight or flight. I'm finna fight you, don't scare me. If I say don't touch me. If I say get out my face. Mm-mm. And I very much cannot go in the haunted house with my parents. So y'all, we was all excited and stuff to go. And I think what really happened was I didn't want to be the punk to not go. And so I ended up going with everybody else. That's how we got there. But, okay, cool, it's okay. Chanel, you gonna toughen up or we gonna go up in here, you know? It's just a judgment house. How bad can it be? Now, like I said, a lot of people from my hometown, you know, that were young around that time, they'll know exactly what the judgment house is. But y'all may not know. So I'm going to tell y'all. So with the judgment house, basically what happens is, like I said, it's a church. You this church does this. And so they pretty much walk you through what hell would be like. And so the judgment house was us getting a taste of hell, because what their whole goal to it, of course, was to lead souls to Christ and to, you know, just to more, because of course children are going to be more likely to go. So they just wanted to, like, kind of like a wake-up call, like, you know, like, if you don't get yourself together, this is what could happen. So, from my recollection, if I can recall correctly, this particular, because they do, like, different scenes is what it is. So they do different scenes. They have different setups. And so they take you through the different setups, and they, like, do, like, a versus. So they'll do like the setup or like the situation and what the outcome would be if that person went to hell, and then they do the setup and what the outcome would be if that person went to heaven. So of course the hell part of it, because it is Halloween, is much longer than the heaven part of it. But baby, so when you're getting ready to walk up in there, it's like, of course, like in the other haunted house, you can't see that the pitch black. So you just walking in there, whatever. You don't know what you're walking into, but you're walking into it. And Chanel has never been the person that you're going to sit in first. So I was very much somewhere in the middle. Okay? Because we're not going to do this. We get in, and like immediately, it's like they do the little, you know, the little talk or whatever they're going to do, you know, explain what's going to go on. And it was kind of like a story, if you will. This one scene, he is getting ready to, looking for the right words because I don't want my video to get taken down. He get ready to go see Jesus, okay? Like, voluntarily go see Jesus. You get my drift? And the devil on his shoulder wins, and so he ends up going to see Jesus. Or he thought he was going to go see Jesus anyway. And so, of course, he does that, and they take you through what his pathway would be after he did that. And we get to see his scene, of course, and he thank you, know. But he is sadly mistaken when he realizes that he not finna see Jesus. Don't want to talk to you. Jesus don't want to talk to you. And so we have to follow him ain't make it to the right side of the other side. So I remember one section of it was like, I want to say like a party, and of course there were underage kids and they were getting drunk or whatever like that. They were getting drunk, they were partying, you know, all this other stuff. And so it kind of leads you up into like the store. So you have people partying, you know, whatever like that. You have this one girl who's like, I want to do this, I want to be here, you know, and she's there, but she's just really uncomfortable. So yeah, but the rest of them partying, drinking, you know, whatever. She came with her friends, you know, the scenario as it goes. So yeah, then the next scene, of course, is like the outcome of the party goers. And you know, like I said, there was a car wreck scene, and drinking and driving and partying and stuff. You know what they say, you don't do drugs and drive, don't drink and drive, because a lot can happen. And so a lot happened. Y'all, when I say a whole production, a whole entire production, they had like caskets, like they had an actual car, literal car, for this scene. Like a car, y'all. Like, oh, y'all been practicing. Y'all been ready for this. And like, it was literally outside, y'all. Outside. So the car wreck happens, and of course they lay it out or whatever like that. And as they lay it out in the floor, they think, you know, they survived. No, they're dead. They're gone. And Satan very much comes and collects. And so then the next scene after that is us actually going to hell.
Hold up.
And y'all, when I say production, a production. So we get to hell, and we're there, and when I say it stunk, I don't know how they conjured up these smells, but y'all, it I was already scared, first of all, and then you want to add smells to it. At this point, y'all don't want me to make it about here, but whatever. Okay, so we go through there, and y'all, when I say, it's like neon lights, flash strobe lights, and all this other stuff. And like, they literally have people, the people that you see from the scenes are in hell, you see them asking you for help, help, help. Like, y'all, when I say a whole production, baby, scared me beyond straight. It was the judgment house. That's what it was. It was them. They did that. Like, whole production, y'all. Like, whole production. And so we get out of there, and at that point, we spooked. Because, of course, you see demons. You see Satan. You see the people that didn't make it to heaven. Like, no, ma'am. And of course, you are scared for your life. So you have these demons, one following you, directing you through, telling you to go. And you scared. Like, scared, scared. Like, what am I doing here? So then, of course, the next scene is after, you know, you go to heaven. I mean, after you go to hell, you go to heaven because they walk you through it. And this is what it would be like had they done this. So the verse society that we walked through heaven, it was the same scenario, different people, except for the one with the car wreck. I should think she did get in the car. She did end up passing away, but she, because she, you know, didn't really want to be there, didn't really, and I may have some of these details mixed up, but that's okay. Y'all get what I'm saying. Like, they showed us the other side. And I'm just like, okay, Jesus, I want to come see you. I don't want to do all this stuff. And basically, their purpose behind doing it very much, it's effective, you know, because you like, okay, all right, Jesus. But then you like, Chanel, wait a minute, because that ain't got nothing to do with what the title says. So, y'all, here's the thing about me. Like, let's just do Chanel 101. So, here's the thing about me. Here's the thing about Chanel. Chanel is very intrigued by Halloween. You know, all the little scary stuff, the haunted houses, scary movies, like, all of that intrigues me. But the thing about me is, if some people get this and some people, it may go clean up your head, and that's okay. A lot of people ain't believe this because a lot of people don't believe in spirits. They don't believe in things transferring and all of that good stuff. And you know, that's you. That's your preference. That's your belief. That's perfectly fine. But with me, not to say that these things take over me, but when I do engage in watching scary movies or going to haunted houses, I get these certain type of feelings, you know, because when you do, and this is not even talking about the judgment house, but this is talking about actual haunted houses. When you go through haunted houses and stuff like that, these people have to connect with these characters, okay? The characters that they play in, they have to put on this production, they have to put on this show. You can even go back and you can watch interviews about people who have been in scary movies and stuff like that. Like, they have to connect. Like, anytime I talk about stuff like this, I always bring up the example of, like, the Joker. Now, I'm not a Batman fanatic, but what I do know is there have been multiple people that played the Joker, and one of them in particular ended up going to see Jesus, if you will, prematurely. That's the term we're going to use for this video. And so you getting my drift, and a lot of it has to do with the fact that when he took on the character of the Joker, it really messed with him mentally. So, yes, things like that happen. And when you are preparing yourself to play characters like that, you have to be careful because spirits do transfer, energies do transfer, you get where I'm going. So when I watch stuff like that, it messes with my inner man. In so many words, we're going to stick with that. So after going through this, it was shaking up my inner man a little bit. I am really spiritually in tune, if you will. I can make another video about this, what I'm talking about, explain it better. But for the purposes of this story, we're going to bypass this. So spiritually in tune is what I was. And like I said, my spiritual mentor took me. Right. And so this particular day, my spiritual mentor was actually supposed to get me home as well. And so I had been talking with her, you know, just about connections, if you will. Follow me, camera. Certain gifts of the spirit, if you will. We use those terms for the sake of the story. This particular night when she was taking me home, we were having one of those conversations again. And me being me, I love Jesus. I do. And we get to talking and I get really, really engaged. And so at this time, we're at my house and we're sitting outside my house. And like I said, I still haven't shaken off these feelings from us being at the judgment house or whatever like that. And so literally what happens is all of a sudden I get really cold. And I start to shake, like shiver, like for real, like I could be fully dressed and I'm still going chills down my spine. So we were sitting there and we were having this conversation and I'm still having these feelings like that. I'm still shivering and shaking, a little cold, a little, you know, I feel little things going on. She's like, I think she's ready.
Hold on a minute, player.
Wait, hold on. Back it up. What, where, who, what?
So she's like, okay, well, let me pray with you before you go in the house or whatever. And so we pray, you know, she sends her blessings and all this other stuff. And me in the back of my head, I'm like, you know, because what we were talking about, I was ready, but I wasn't ready. I really wasn't ready. So I go in the house, and like I said, with me, the reason I don't watch scary movies or go to haunted houses like that, unless I know I'm not gonna sleep by myself, because I get seeing stuff and my inner spirit is just, I'm really sensitive when it comes to stuff like that. So yeah, that night I really couldn't sleep. And so she was like, well, she told me, what she was like, just pray, you go and just pray or whatever like that. And of course I already couldn't sleep, I was already nervous, so I was in there praying down the house, y'all, praying, do you hear me, praying like I never prayed before. And all of a sudden, I felt something. And it got a hold of me. And y'all, so I'm getting to praying. And then all of a sudden, I start to actually realize that these are actual words. And I'm telling y'all this in a long time, but I promise y'all it happened in a split second. I start to feel it. And next thing I know, I shook. And if y'all don't know nothing else, let me tell you about the Holy Spirit, because that's exactly what it was. Y'all thought I was dealing with another spirit, but it was the Holy Spirit. That's all it was. That was the Holy Spirit. It was the Holy Spirit. And I thought I was ready to receive those blessings at 13, 12 years old, but I wouldn't. Because when I say I was shook, I don't think I slept the rest of the night, y'all. Sitting in the car having a conversation with her, I'm really, the Holy Spirit said, no, you're not. Boop. Do you hear me? No, ma'am. Y'all, I couldn't sleep for the rest of that night. It had really shook me up. And let me tell you why. This is the thing. If anybody else ever told you this, I'm going to tell you this. Because someone else told me this. The Holy Spirit is like a gentleman. If you tell a gentleman no, they're gonna take that no. But if you allow the Holy Spirit to move in you, then the Holy Spirit will have his way. So because your girl, little old 13, 12 year old me, wasn't ready, the Holy Spirit was like, okay, that ain't no problem. But see, the thing about it was, I didn't receive the gift of speaking in tongues until college. But that was not my first encounter with the Holy Spirit. Yeah. This was the story about the time with my first encounter with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost. Not just in the ghost, y'all. Because y'all thought y'all was coming for a scary story time. I am a church girl at heart. Okay, baby? I love the Lord. He heard my cry. And people ever grow. You hear me? And Lord, I thank you because he know who to give him gifts to and who not to give them to. Y'all, that night, I ain't get no sleep at all. I was up watching Disney Junior. And was, that's how long I had stayed up. On Wednesday night, very much had to be at school the next morning, but it's okay. But that is it for this video, you guys. It is right at 8 o'clock. I have to get on live and announce my winner for my giveaway. And if you haven't, you know, paid attention to my giveaways, then you really should. But that's okay. So it's 8 o'clock and it actually is Halloween. So I'm only going to be on live for like 5 minutes because I hate getting on live. And then I'm going to end this video and upload it so that you guys can have this video for Halloween. So happy Halloween to you guys. Stay safe. And just be good. Like, be safe. And I'll see you guys in the next video. This is all you get. This is all you get. This is all you get. I know the background looks a little different. And that's okay. In my hometown, in my grandma's. This is it. This is so good. I hope y'all have a good time today.